What's going on, Rational Roundtable? This is the Violent Buddha. I want to really just have a discussion with you about your ideas of bending space-time and moving at the speed of light, because I'm really interested in these kinds of things, and nobody out here in my town is, except for my brother, and he's, like, never here when I'm here, so, you know, anyway. But, like, I was thinking, like, you were talking about being able to possibly travel faster than the speed of light by bending space-time, you know? I think there's a fundamental flaw in that a lot of people don't think about. Because, I mean, like, the example usually given is, like, say this is space, right? You know what I mean? Like, they're giving you this example, right? And then they're going, like, one side of this page is point A, like, the other side of this page is point B, right? Right? And then, like, what you're doing is you're getting, you know, point A, you know, where you're at, and what you're doing is you're just, like creating something so massive to where you can just bend point A, not really bending point A, but bend the space in between the points and bring them together, so that way you can just, you know, basically hop over and then go over to the other side. But, like, my issue with that is like, how are you gonna know? Like, how could we figure out a way to keep something that massive in front of the ship the entire time? Because, I mean, like when this bend happens from whatever thing or, you know, whatever technology we're using to bend the space, that gravitational well is going to be insane. Insane. Like, that's a lot of gravity in order to bend space like that. Like, that's crazy. You know what I mean? So, it might not even be possible because of the amount of mass that you're going to have to generate to bend space like this. It might not even be possible to get space to pop back so you can get to point B. Like, that's something I think about all the time, but at the same time, it probably could be done, because I'm not too sure about this, but I think, you know, they've done calculations on, like what the mass would have to be to cause a black hole, so I think we know, like, a range between just an incredibly massive dark star and a black hole, you know. I don't know, don't quote me on that. I'll actually probably look it up here in a second. But I really don't think that's possible. I mean, without either, completely, you know, keeping space in that bent shape forever, or without, like, popping out, like, creating a black hole, like, completely on accident, and then sucking the ship down into the black hole, and then you're screwed anyway, you know? So I don't think bending space like that is at all a possibility. I'd love to hear your thoughts back on this. This is not just me, like, rambling at you. This is hopefully turning into us rambling about things that we think about. Because obviously you've thought about this quite a bit. I know I do. And that's my issue with that little theory for bending space-time. And honestly, that's pretty much the only one I know. Ow. But, and then another thing, you know, you were talking about we might have the ability to go, faster than, or at least at the speed of light. Again, I think there's kind of a fundamental flaw in that, because organic material, or just, like, man-made stuff, or just, larger things in general, or anything that's not light. There we go. Like photons. You know, anything that is not a photon has too much mass to go at the speed of light. Like, it can't work that way. I don't think we'll ever be able to reach light speed. I think we might be able to get, like, a type of warp drive. That would be pretty dope, to be able to go about, you know, half or maybe even three quarters of the speed of light. Like, that would be, that would be crazy. Like, I don't even know if people in, or stuff that we could build would be able to handle the gravitational forces from that, you know? Like, that would be pretty nuts. But I do think, and something else that I've thought about, you know, before is, like, I think eventually humans will be interplanetary. You know what I mean? Like, eventually we're going to find another star or another planet where we can at least colonize, or at least, you know, set up, like, tourist vacations to. Like, I imagine a time, like, when that happens. And then, you know, I was thinking even deeper into it, and it's like, once that happens, you know, like, once there's other human civilizations living on other planets, maybe within our solar system, or maybe even outside of our solar system. Well, obviously, it would have to be outside the solar system if it's not inside, right? Jeez. excuse me. But I see some serious Star Wars stuff happening, right? Because one planet's going to be like, oh, our planet's way better than your planet. And then the other planet's going to be like, nah, man, forget your planet. My planet's way better than your planet. And then, you know, you're just going to have a star. But that's some sci-fi stuff I like to think about from time to time. But I also think we are at least working on, like, a type of warp drive. Like, I think it's called an ion propulsion system. I might be wrong. I check right now, but, you know, the video's already almost 10 minutes, so I'm not going to waste your time on that, unless you want to get back to me, and then, you know, we'll just keep going back and forth. Like, I'm all down to talk about stuff like this. If you have any kind of, like, theoretical, like, sci-fi type idea you want to, like, talk to me about, or, like, bounce ideas off of, please do. I love this stuff, dude. You don't even understand how much I love this stuff. But, actually, I'm going to let you go, and then I'm going to do some research on this ion propulsion system. Yeah, I suggest you do it, too. It sounds pretty dope so far from what I've heard, at least from talking to my brother. But, peace out, Rational Roundtable. Another great video, like always. Peace.